Hey guys, so watch this video for Monday, which would be March 15th. Let me start by saying, if you're not a lifetime member, or you're not even a member at all, we are pulling the lifetime membership option off the site this coming week sometime. And it's simply because we got probably 350 people in the chat room on an average every day. Because we have the lifetime option, we have people that pop in, you know, whenever they can. And sometimes it's once a month when they get a day off work or whatever. So it varies, but we're averaging like 350. And I don't want to get too populated where the room's going to be clutter filled. We're pretty good with the rules and most people don't clutter. But anyway, and that's obviously the most popular option. So if you're on the fence or you've been thinking about it, this is the time, because next week's going to be gone. It won't be gone forever, but it's going to be gone for a while because the room's getting somewhat crowded. All right, anyway. A couple highlights. Well, here's the SPY, another narrow range, but kind of hanging out near all-time highs. I had a very boring morning. I think at one point I was like up $30 on the day after a few hours. I'd had a couple stupid trades and nothing really to speak of. And then nailed and called it over the mic to Tilray through 28 here. And we got a quick move to almost 29.50. I had a couple nice trades in eyes, but my third idea in it was right here through 13, and I didn't take that one. I gave the idea in the room, but I actually missed the biggest move of the day. I still think I made over 1,000 maybe in eyes, trading it a couple times when it started this move and so on. But again, I'll confess. I had poured a crown black and told everybody in chat, hey, I'm starting my weekend early. It was probably like, what, 3 o'clock, 3:15. I said, so I'm going to be responsible and not trade whilst drinking. That just seems like a terrible idea, right? And I had a nice day and I had a nice week. So, but I did give the idea in chat through 13, and I held to my own rule and didn't trade while drinking. But anyway, huge rip there at the end of the day. Happy for people. A ton of people got that. Heck, one member emailed me a screenshot. They made over 20 grand on Friday, which, by the way, I never do. But that's pretty impressive. Anyway. What are we watching for Monday? Nope. Yeah, Monday. Let's see. And by the way, if you're watching this video and it's still the weekend, we push our clocks ahead this weekend an hour. So don't let that throw you off on Monday morning. ENTX is something I'm watching. It closed way off its highs, but take Friday's candle out of it. Thursday gapped up, ran, closed at its lows. This look right here is a recipe for bleeding lower for like the next couple weeks. And next thing you know, it gaps up. So you had shorts caught. And I think that's where this move came. You know, it ran, and then that stupid volatility halt, ran again, halted, and then didn't do much, kind of bled lower the rest of the day. So is this one worth watching? Now it is, but it's not, you know, it's extended, but at the same time closed well off its highs. Any stock that's doing this kind of move, as a day trader, I want to keep that on a chart somewhere, so I will. MVIS had a nice pop on Friday. Somebody messaged me on Twitter. They said, I saw this was on your gap playlist. Did you trade it? And my embarrassing answer is no, but it did give a setup. I just didn't see it. Look at this. Those of you in our chat room, you know the setup, right? It's on the gap playlist. There's the opening candle. It sells off. And as it comes back up through the highs, look at that. Just rips. And I never got a trade in that thing. I did put out a pullback idea in it, but I never got, it didn't come down to my entry, so I didn't get filled. So no trades in MVIS, even though it ripped. Anyway, we're going to watch it again because it had a strong day. Seal, big pop, but closing well off its highs. So look at that volume, over 300 million shares. Going to keep that on my radar. Already talked about EYES. Had this huge move, then the gap up, a couple red days, then the gap down, now a couple green days. It moves really nicely when it does get going. So as a day trader, again, I'm going to have it on watch. AVEO, huge move, then a gap up, huge move down. And then the third day, you know, bulls win, bears win, right? Third day, nobody wins. Closes right where it opens. But again, it's a big mover, so we're going to keep that one on watch as well. Tilray or any of the pot stocks are really strong. This one's not on the list, but OGI was on the list going into Friday. And look at that move. I never took a trade in that one either, by the way. So Tilray is a pot stock I've chosen to watch. Certainly interesting. Back here, 29.60 high, 29.44 high on Friday. Certainly above this range, but you know, all the pot stocks move together. So Tilray's the one I've chosen to watch. They're all starting to look pretty good on their charts. That's TLRYFINV. Quiet inside day. Certainly looks interesting. Maybe back through nine on Monday. EBON is a Bitcoin play. Very strong move. I'll show you 5-minute candles here. I mean, this thing just kept climbing and climbing, and really just spent the rest of the afternoon flagging with no higher move or lower move after that. It's just, you know, but it closed so strong. It looks like maybe the biggest volume ever for that stock. So I'm going to watch that one. And just like the pot stocks, I'm going to watch other Bitcoin plays too. I've thrown ANTE on there too because it's kind of interesting. Had this big pop. It's being touted as a Bitcoin play. I don't do enough research to even tell you if EBON is a legit Bitcoin play, but I do know the symbols that are thrown in, you know, like Riot, Mara, and GRNQ. There's a bunch of them. This one made a really nice move 3 sessions ago. 360 to 549, then an inside day and another inside day, but both of them close in green. So this one feels like it's building. If Bitcoin rips, I like this chart a lot. BB, remember BlackBerry? Really strong day, and it closed pretty darn strong. Look at that. Closed, went out basically at its highs. It certainly looks interesting over this $12 area. We'll keep an eye on that one for a possible setup. PDSB, big pop on Thursday, inside day on Friday, but went out at its high. So it's certainly worth watching for an A plus long setup on Monday. And then lastly, EXPR had this nice move and then looked like it was reversing. And then next thing you know, it's kind of curling right back up. So I want to watch that one too. That's plenty to watch, and we'll add gappers to this list in the pre-market. And that's all I've got. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. I'm doing this on a Saturday, so I've got the rest of my weekend free now. And I'll see everybody in the chat room on Monday morning.